Hey YouTube, MockRacer4 here with a review on the Bachmann branch line class 57XX. Now this one is the 32-215 57XX pannier tank, 5775 GWR green, 8 pin DCC ready. I already fitted it with a decoder, which I got at the same time as the locomotive and some rolling stock, and that was the 36-553 8-pin, 1-amp, 3-function decoder. Now, I wouldn't exactly recommend that one for this locomotive because the wires on the 36553 are so long I had to take and loop the wires. We'll make the wires do a 180 and then tape them together like that to shorten them up. So I wouldn't recommend using the 36553 decoder in this locomotive unless you figure out some way to make all the wires fit within the actual locomotive body shell, all with relative ease. Again, standard Bachmann packaging like the Tornado, cardboard outer sleeve with brief history on the back. Then inside you've got the actual cardboard case, well, cardboard box containing the ice block packaging. Now, before I go any farther, this one went on to be London Transport L89, which last year or the year before you could get from Bachmann in the 57XX as London Transport L89, and that was this locomotive right here. Now you can also get the 57XX in BR Black, Late Crest and BR Black, Early Crest, and then you can get the London, the Metropolitan train set from Bachmann Branch Line. It's a brand new one, and it's got 57XX in it, in London Transport livery, but it's not L89, it's L97, which just so happens to be, I believe, one of the other preserved ones. There are 16 of these left in the world. All of them are in England. Some are operational, some aren't. But, you know, at least there are some left. This one is preserved at a railway museum or preserved railway in England, but not in operation. It's a static engine. Well, it's a static display. But at least it's still around. Now for the basic background on the 57XX. There were 863 of them built between 1929 and 1950 at GWR Swindon, Armstrong Whitworth, WG Bagnall, Bear Peacock & Co., Kerr Stewart, North British Locomotive and Yorkshire Engine Company. And the numbers were at Swindon 585, Armstrong Whitworth 25, WG Bagnall 100, Bear Peacock & Co. 25, Kerr Stewart 25, North British Locomotive 75, Yorkshire Engine Company 25. Now this one is part of the 57 to 5799 number series. This one was built at Swindon. Now for the 57 to 5799 number series, the production of those was split up between North British Locomotive and Swindon. Now, the ones built at North British were 5700 to 5749, and then 5750 to 5799 were built at Swindon. This one was part of, this one being 5775, was part of the group built at Swindon. Now, everyone knows the 57XX. Now, all kids nowadays know the 57XX as Duck the Great Western Engine. In the railway series, Duck's number was 5741, if you look carefully at his number plates and his early appearances in the railway series. Now, while I was doing the research, I found that there really was a 5741 and that just so happened to be part of the group built at North British. But anyway, back to the locomotive itself. Again, standard ice block packaging, except this version was designed for a tank engine. Flap at one end, just open up the flap, flip the top up, pull the engine out. Now this has sprung buffers front and rear, and them coupling pockets front and rear. Now again, I already have this fitted with DCC, and while I did that, I took and fitted it with a Bachmann EasyMate Mark II NEM compatible knuckle coupling and just removed the front NEM pocket altogether, because I don't really see myself pulling trains with this engine, with the front of this engine coupled to the train right now anyway. Yeah, so I just removed it altogether, plus you kinda gotta remove it to get to the screws underneath along the center line of the loco chassis at either end to pull the body shell off to fit it with DCC. Now it is a very well detailed model, a lot of detailing along the top, including these little pipes and all the other little pipes and domes and knobs and levers and handrails up towards the front, and all the riveting along the side. You've got all the little piping detail down there, a little toolbox on the side, handrails all the way down, the brake rigging, the number plate, this little GWR sort of power classification mark. Let's see if my camera can focus in on it. It's pretty faint, but I know there is a C there, because the 57s were under GWR power classification, a Class C locomotive. Now, it's also got brake pipes front and rear, as well as the dummy coupling hooks. Same thing along this side for the side detail, handrails, all the little piping toolbox, brake rods, the little ladders, this little pipe thing there. Then on the back you've got some hooks, some lamp irons, a couple of little handrails, and then the little door at the back of the cab, as well as the windows. Now for the interior detail, the reverser rod is clearly visible because it's actually part of the body shell. And then for the rest of the cab interior, not sure if can get this at the right angle for you to see. There. It's got a brake lever, well, the brake lever on the far side of the cab along with the throttle lever. Along the top, those would be the injectors and the live steam ejector. All the normal stuff for the rest of the inside of the cab. Along the back, not a whole lot of detail. You've got a little toolbox looking thing right there. Coal bunker hatch down there. It's a very well detailed locomotive. Now, for the next part of the review, this will be a 2-3 part review. The next part of the review will feature the rolling stock I got for it. A 20 ton towed brake van and VR bauxite, and a 12-ton Mogo van MBR bauxite. Now, both of those are Great Western, so they do match the locomotive. The only thing that doesn't match the locomotive between these and the locomotive is the livery. These are BR bauxite, not Great Western gray. But, you know, I like the brown color opposed to the gray with alongside the green of the locomotive. So I'll be back with the review on the freight cars.